Today on Roanoke County Business Partners, we will interview George Child, President and CEO of Richfield Living, so he can tell us about their expansion, which will include 140 new independent living residences, a state-of-the-art nursing facility, and a town center. We'll see their groundbreaking ceremony, as well as renderings of what the expansion will look like when complete. Next, we will reveal three Roanoke County businesses that were Gold Division winners in the Gauntlet Business Plan competition.
We're here today at the groundbreaking ceremony for Richfield Living. They're celebrating today Richfield Living's Project Home Vision 2020 plan. And with me today is George Child, the president and CEO of Richfield Living. Welcome to our show, George.
Thank you, Jill. So, great to be here.
Thank you. Tell us about this project and what it means to Richfield.
For Richfield, this represents a new era, an opportunity for us to expand our independent living offerings, take our nursing home and turn it into the household model, which is really centered around the residents. A new exciting town center, which is going to allow us to bring our residents together all at the center of our community. So a lot going on today, and we're very excited about all of it.
So Richfield is well known for high quality living and health care, for aging in place. Tell us about how many residents you have and employees here at Richfield.
Right now, as we stand here, we have about 600 residents on this campus that are cared for in all levels of care. We have independent living, we have memory care, we have assisted living, we have transitional care, and we have skilled nursing. All total about 600 residents. And it takes about 500 team members to take care of those folks. So it's a good-sized operation.
Well, we appreciate all that you're doing in our community and for the great services that you're providing our citizens. This campus is very well known as being the most beautiful campus in the county and probably the entire Roanoke Valley. So the landscape is going to change a little bit here in the future. You're going to have new buildings coming up. Tell us about how that's going to look.
We believe, Jill, that we have the finest setting in the valley. Two beautiful mountain ranges, two beautiful lakes, very walkable campus. So we've been blessed with that. We believe that this plan really allows us to take advantage of that. We're going to have a new apartment building right here where we stand overlooking this lake. So our residents will have balconies. They'll be able to be overlooking the lake, better taking advantage of our lakes. I mentioned the walkability. We think that's important.
I think you said, what is it, five new buildings that you're...
Five new buildings. First, we're going to have our upscale apartments. We call them villas. They'll be right at the front of our campus. They'll be the lead into our campus. That building will be completed first. Hopefully, we'll have occupants within about 11 to 12 months, the first building. And then our town center, followed by a large apartment building right here. While that's all going on, we're building a new nursing home. It will be attached to our current transitional care center, and it will be the household model that I referenced earlier, which really is the first to the valley. We're the first in the valley on a large scale to take our skilled nursing facility into a home-like environment.
So I love the town center model. Tell our viewers what that's like. What is it going to look like?
Well, for a long time, we've talked about a town center on this campus. Others have it. We have not. This will be a first for us. So the town center will be first for us. I like to describe it as a place where we bring people together. It will be attached to two of our large nursing centers. It'll just be across the road from our villas. It will be attached to our skilled nursing facility. So it will be a place that will bring people together for a meal. We'll have three opportunities for meals. Sit-down dining, a cafe, and a pub. We'll also have a chapel, so people can go there to worship. We'll have a place they can go to work out. We'll have a spa where they can go for manicures, pedicures. So we think it's going to help us bring this community together, not just the new buildings we're building. We'll also be designed with an entrance on that side up there, so it'll be easy access for our other buildings.
It'll be a great place for visitors to come and gather with the residents of the community and spend time together in a beautiful campus setting.
Let me tell you about our restaurant, though. Look at this setting. The restaurant's going to overlook this lake, and it's going to have both indoor and outdoor seating. Mm-hmm. And you're right, we want to attract the community to come in and take advantage of that restaurant. Mm-hmm. It will bring a whole new dimension to our campus. And that's all in the town center.
What an absolutely beautiful environment for it. And this has been a massive project. Oh. It's about $93 million investment that you're making in the community to provide services to citizens who want to live here and enjoy the quality amenities that you're providing.
Yes, we do realize it's a big project. I do like to say we had a much greater risk of doing nothing than take the risk and reaching out and doing this to provide for our community into the future. Because we had some antiquated buildings. We had buildings that had reached the end of their useful life. And they're gonna have to come down and then be replaced by these new buildings. But we are very, very excited about what it's gonna bring to this community. And at all levels of care, Richfield has always been committed to the full continuum of care. Independent living, assisted living, and skilled nursing. And we're gonna continue to do that.
George, thank you so much for your investment, your partnership, working with the county through this process. We're glad to see you right-sizing and modernizing this campus for the future. Thank you.
Thank you. Jill, I want to thank you and the county because you've been great to work with as we've worked our way through this. It's been a relatively long journey. The county sponsored our bonds. We wouldn't be able to do any of this without that. And we really appreciate that.
It's been a great long-term partnership for 85
years.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Great. Thank you.
Roanoke County's 419 Town Center unlocks new retail and residential investment opportunities. In-depth retail market analysis found opportunities for as much as 150,000 square feet of new retail and entertainment space. This is due to the fact that the surrounding community enjoys high incomes and a low cost of living, which means they have more disposable income. Couple this with one of the highest traffic counts in the region and a metropolitan statistical area of 318,582 people, and you have the formula for fantastic retail and entertainment investment opportunities. In addition, a comprehensive analysis of the area's residential market found a strong demand for rental housing in which the 419 Town Center area could absorb up to 1,000 units per year over the next 5 years. Interested developers, investors, and business owners can call Roanoke County Economic Development at 540-772-2069 with questions and details on the market study.
Welcome. I'm with Leslie Mann. Her and her husband are the owners of Valley Cryotherapy. Leslie, thank you for joining me. Could you tell me what is Valley Cryotherapy?
At Valley Cryotherapy, we do whole body cryotherapy where you are exposed to extremely low temperatures, around negative 220 degrees for 3 minutes. And it helps with pain, decrease inflammation, gives you a boost of energy, just makes you feel good all over. Really.
Right, right. And you're the only business that does this in this area, correct?
Correct. Correct.
Somebody wants to do this, they either come to you or they drive several hours
correct.
To get someplace.
Correct, yep.
So now, I know you've been in business, we spoke to you like a year ago, you've been in business for about a year.
A year.
And now you've participated in the gauntlet. Why did you decide to do the gauntlet?
My husband is, we're both in the healthcare field, but we don't have business experience. Mm-hmm. So the gauntlet has been a big asset to us, learning how to operate a small business, connecting with other small businesses, mm-hmm. just kind of getting that learning curve that we didn't have before we opened this business.
Gotcha. And so what did you get, what do you think the main thing was? You know, you just listed a bunch of things, but what would be your top thing you got out of your
experience? I love networking through the gauntlet with a lot of people that are in the same like-mindedness as myself, and the same goals as myself of really starting a small business and really supporting each other. I think that
right.
that was a...
Right.
Yeah, so Valley Cryo is a unique business, but you have other businesses in the area that do neuromuscular massage.
Correct.
You have Total U Health, which is a totally different thing with laser therapy.
Correct.
So it gives you that opportunity to network, which I think is one of the strengths
yes.
of the gauntlet.
And I think with those type of businesses and myself, if we all work together and send each other patients, the patients have a better outcome.
Right.
So doing different
you
therapies.
Have a website?
We do. We have yeah. a website, valleycryo.net.
That's great. That's great. And so if somebody wants to learn more about cryotherapy or just come visit your shop and get some treatments, they can go to valleycryo.net.
Correct. Or look us up on Facebook.
Great. Well, thank you for joining me.
Thanks for having me.
And thank you. If you have any kind of illness that you think cryotherapy might help, contact Leslie and find out if her business can help you. Thank you for joining us.
The Roanoke County Economic Development Department, in partnership with the City of Roanoke Economic Development Department, organizes a wide variety of free workshops for businesses and entrepreneurs. Whether you have a new business idea or have been in business for years, there is sure to be a workshop that matches your needs. Workshops include, but are not limited to, marketing, finance, apprenticeship programs, cybersecurity, programs to cut your business's electric bill, entrepreneurship, and much more. If you would like to learn more, please contact Jay Brinchick at 540-772-2070 or email jbrinchick@roanokecountyva.gov.
Welcome. I am with Austin Bailey. He is the owner of a business called Why Not Boat With Us. Now, they boat down in Smith Mountain Lake, but he's actually located in Roanoke County, his business. Austin, thank you for joining me.
Thank you guys so much for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Austin, tell me a little bit about your business. What is it?
So we do private boat charters on Smith Mountain Lake.
Okay.
I'll give it to you simply. Mm-hmm. We take all the liability and we take all the risk out of boating,
yep.
put it on myself, the captain.
I like that.
That way people in Roanoke can come to Smith Mountain Lake and have a worry-free, stress-free day on Smith Mountain Lake.
Right, you captain them around the,
exactly.
around the place.
Exactly.
So why did you decide to participate in the gauntlet?
That's a great question, and it's actually a funny story. Kelly Turner, mm-hmm. who's a part of the Advancement
yes,
Foundation,
yep.
actually chartered one of my boats for her bachelorette party.
Okay.
So that's how we became acquainted, and I participated last year.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't compete due to some extenuating circumstances.
Right.
However, this year I said, I'm going to compete, I'm going to go after it, I'm going to be an entrepreneur, and yep. I'm going to participate this year. So that's
right.
honestly the reason that I competed.
Well, good. That's good for Kelly. Kelly is great, and the whole
that's
staff
fantastic.
With the Advancement Foundation, and the fact that they've put on this gauntlet is great.
Just, they're fantastic.
What would you say would be, you know, the biggest thing you got out of participating in the gauntlet?
Honestly, Jay, the biggest thing that I got out of it was, originally, I was focused on the people that visit Smith Mountain Lake.
Right.
Right, the vacationers.
Mm-hmm.
They really taught me. Amanda Forrester came in and taught me that there are other people to look for
right,
in business, right.
right?
You don't have to be closed-minded.
Right.
So in that session, I learned that corporate offices, real estate offices, rental organizations, wedding parties, all these different people
mm-hmm.
are people that I can go after
right.
in business.
Right.
And it's completely opened my eyes as a business owner
right.
to not only what I'm doing in my business, but also how much money I can make and how much I can give back to the Roanoke area.
That's great. You know, and you mentioned Amanda Forrester. She's actually with the Small Business Development
exactly.
Center. One of the great things that the Gauntlet does and the Advancement Foundation is they partner with different organizations to help bring you these great,
100%.
Great services. Well, I appreciate you taking the time to speak
Absolutely.
With us. I'm so glad you participated in the Gauntlet. I'm glad that they helped you realize that there are other markets to tap into, especially locally. And I wish you nothing but the best of luck with your business. So
well, thank you so much, Jake.
Thank you.
I appreciate your time.
And thank you for joining us.
Support your local farmers, growers, and craftsmen by visiting the Catawba Valley Farmers Market. Most products at the market are grown or baked within a 10-mile radius, which means you get fresh produce and baked items. Items you can find at the Catawba Valley Farmers Market include meats, seasonal fruits and vegetables, baked goods, eggs, jams, hanging baskets, potted plants, and local handmade arts and crafts. The market is held every Thursday from 3:30 to 7 p.m. mid-May through mid-October at the Catawba Community Center on Catawba Creek Road. The market is a collaborative project between the Virginia Tech Catawba Sustainability Center, Roanoke County, and Catawba Valley Ruiting Club and the local community.
Welcome. We are at the Gauntlet Award Ceremony, and with me is Terry Kahn. She is the owner of Roanoke Neuromuscular. Terry, thank you for joining me. Terry, can you tell me a little bit about your business? Is this a startup, or have you been in business a while?
I was in business before with a neuromuscular massage practice, but I suspended operations in order to go to physical therapy school and get more education, and now I'm starting up again what I did before.
Great. And where is your business located?
Southwest Roanoke County, Old Cave Spring Road.
Oh, that's great. That's great. Now, you're part of the Gauntlet. You had run a business before.
Yes.
So why did you decide to participate in the Gauntlet?
Because my thing is helping people overcome pain, and I've studied so many different ways to do it that my elevator pitch was all over the place.
Gotcha.
I would say it and people still didn't know what I did. So as I practiced my elevator pitch week after week in the Gauntlet, I was able to clarify that and realize that I needed to clarify my actual offerings too. Later I'll offer physical therapy and a whole bunch of other things, but for now I'm keeping it simple. Roanoke Neuromuscular, the massage that clears pain, simple and people understand it.
That's great. That's great. So if you were to kind of explain slightly further beyond that little catchphrase, mm-hmm. what exactly is different about your business than maybe a massage therapist?
I am a massage therapist.
Right.
Neuromuscular therapy is a branch of massage developed specifically to clear pain from trigger points. Pain mm-hmm. can have many different causes,
yeah.
but trigger points are so common that even when people have other diagnoses like arthritis or sciatica or something, quite often trigger points are involved too. So when they are, we can clear them and the person gets dramatically better.
That's great. That's great. So what made you decide to participate in the Gauntlet? And what did you, I mean, you told me what you decide, why you did, but what did you really feel you got out of the Gauntlet?
Night and day, helping me clarify what I need to do to get started. A startup has to do thousands of things, and it helped me focus on these are the steps I need to focus right now. But just as important is it connected me with so many resources in the Roanoke Valley, both organizations and people, so that I'm not trying to do this on my own. There's a world of help out there, and they connected me to it.
That's great. One of the big things that people get out of the Gauntlet is the ongoing relationship that they have with their whole cohort and,
yes.
and the mentors that they work with.
Yes.
Well, I want to thank you for joining us. I want to thank you for participating in the Gauntlet.
My pleasure.
I'll tell you that I might become a customer of yours.
you
sounded good what you have to
Terrific.
Offer.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you for joining us for Roanoke County Business Partners. If you have any questions about this show, want to start a business, or need business assistance, please contact the Roanoke County Economic Development Office at 540-772-2069 or email jbrenchick@roanokecountyva.gov, and you can always visit our website at yesroanoke.org.